आयोग डॉक्टर डी के पॉल सेक्रेटरी हेल्थ श्रीमती प्रीति सूदन आर ऑनरेबल हेल्थ मिनिस्टर्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट स्टेट्स ऑफ इंडिया डॉक्टर एस वेंकटेश डॉक्टर बी के मोंगा डॉक्टर यास्मी डॉक्टर जयदीप मिस्टर मार्क ए वाइट ऑल आर डेवलपमेंट पार्टनर्स मीडिया लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन आई एम वेरी प्लीज टू वेलकम यू ऑल to Pradhan Mantri Surakshit Matritva Abhiyan, I pledge for 9 Achievers Awards. We've been, in fact, working for a long time to provide medical care to our expected mothers during pregnancy, at the time of childbirth and post-childbirth. But less than 2 years back, we started this new initiative of PMSMA with a view to intensify our efforts to reach out to every single woman who misses out on antenatal care due to various reasons. And with this, the government actually intended to provide quality antenatal care to all our expectant mothers, to a wide network of both private and government doctors who would provide voluntary services in the designated medical facilities on the 9th of every month. And today is a day to celebrate our achievements, which are a lot, and also to recognize the efforts that has been made by different state governments, the individuals and the organizations who have worked relentlessly to convert this campaign into a social movement as was envisioned by our Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi ji. And it is my pleasure to tell you that in less than 2 years of its launch, we have been able to provide 1.3 crore antenatal checkups and identify 6.5 lakh high-risk pregnancies. Constant innovation has also been a hallmark of our program, our campaign. For example, we used red stickers on the mother and child protection cards to segregate women with high-risk pregnancies in order to ensure their proper follow-up and special care. We understand that the pregnancy can become high-risk at any time for a varied number of reasons. It could be a high BP, our Honorable Secretary was also talking about it, gestational diabetes or severe anemia. So a detailed antenatal checkup by a qualified, skilled doctor is a must so that we can avoid any complication during pregnancy and childbirth. And for this, we made several provisions and several arrangements, including all diagnostic services, ultrasound and other screening tests to rule out the possibility of various life-threatening diseases. And besides, we even distributed essential drugs like iron and calcium supplements to all the expectant mothers under the program. And all this was free of cost. Also, to monitor the quality of care which was being provided at the PMSMA sites, we undertook an evaluation process, not just with the intent of assessing the status of implementation, but also to identify the bottlenecks and to offer solutions for a mid-course correction. And I'm very happy to inform you that in our evaluation process, which involved almost 9 different states, we found that 80% of the pregnant women who were the beneficiaries of this program were very satisfied with the kind of services which were provided, whether it was in terms of examination by the doctor or the availability of diagnostic tests or the provision of the counseling services. And I also want to thank our field level functionaries, our ASHA workers, who are an integral part of this campaign and who were entrusted with the responsibility of mobilizing these expectant mothers and bringing them to the health facilities on the 9th of every month. And I am very delighted to say that their effort has been commendable, and more than 83% of the beneficiaries have told that they were being informed about these services by the ASHA karyakartris. So they really need an applause for the commendable work that they have done. Effective interpersonal communication by the health workers, the community organizations and local leaders has gone a long way in ensuring that women in large numbers turn up at the PMSMA sites on the 9th of every month. We of course needed support from the state governments, the Indian Medical Association, the Federation Obstetric and Gynecological Society of India, as well as various developmental partners to make this campaign a success. And I'm very happy to report that they extended their full cooperation and support and rendered exemplary services, and my sincere thanks to all on this very occasion. I also want to thank the media, whether it is local, regional, wherever they are, they have played a very important role in creating a mass awareness about this program, and women were able to turn in large numbers, and we are very encouraged by the kind of results that are to be seen. I also want to mention about the states who have performed very well. There are three states who have achieved the SDG targets of MMR who are with us today: the Honorable Ministers from Kerala, the Honorable Minister from Tamil Nadu, and the Honorable Minister from Maharashtra, who have been awarded. Five states who have shown outstanding decline in MMR: UP, Uttarakhand, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, and once again Kerala. So when states perform this way, it really encourages and motivates us to give a greater impetus to the program. I congratulate all the winners of I Pledge for 9 Achievers Awards, and I urge everyone connected with the campaign to keep up the spirit and work very hard so that we can reach each and every expectant mother and provide her the special care that she truly deserves during those critical 9 months. Thank you once again, all of you, very much.